Hey, Baz, you smashed it out of the ballpark yesterday. Well done to you.
Morning, Zabe. Morning, Jenna. And Lockie, thank you. Appreciate it very much. Look, Arnie did all the work, obviously. Or as you know, though, as the joke goes, I couldn't have done it without her.
And you're lucky Thorpey didn't yell over the top. Yeah, he was in and around it, but you're lying there. To be a legend, you have to beat a legend. Bang.
Don't worry, Zabe. I had the right hand on the left side. I know you're a very good swimmer, big fella. Just hold it for a little bit. Just hold it. No, it was so much goes on in those moments. And, you know, clearly you sort of think, what could you say or what might you say and all of those things. I must admit, when Ariane Titmus beat Ledecky 2 years ago at the World Championships, I was in the newsroom at 7 and, you know, the news came through. It was the first one that we hadn't covered for a while. And I thought, geez, she's going to be a chance, obviously, in Rio. And at the time, I thought, I wonder what you say. You do have those thoughts. And it's probably about beating the legend or something like that. And I didn't think about it again until a couple of days before the games. And it still seemed like the right thing to say because that was the story, that she was beating the legend. So fortunately, it came out all right. Arnie, an amazing swim, and you feel a bit self-indulgent talking about it this way, but an incredible swim, and you just hope that you can add to the moment ever so slightly.
No, I absolutely agree. Sometimes the commentary I don't think does, but I reckon you absolutely added to the moment yesterday, Baz, so well done. But can I ask what your line was if it went the other way?
Yeah, you know, it's funny. You're not the first one to ask that, Dave, and there was no line. There was no line for the other way. It was just call it as you saw it.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And she's back in the water today now. So she swims again very soon. Listening to Akadaka, I hope, again off the mum's playlist. She loves the Triple M music, and she's just a superstar, Ariane Titmus. So understated, a lovely person. And I think we're all so pleased for her because she has beaten one of the biggest names in world swimming.
Yeah, it is true. She was listening to this, Baz. I think she had the live broadcast of Triple M Breakfast with Basil, Zave and Jenna just pumping through the headphones.
Smart. She could win the Triple M triple play, the 10K.
Yeah. Hey, Baz, what are you looking forward to today?
Kaylee McEwen, who is the world record holder in the 100 backstroke.
Oh,
tragic story. She lost her dad to brain cancer 11 months ago. His dream was to see his daughters swim at the Olympic Games. Only Kaylee made the team. Taylor, who's previously been, didn't make it. And she's got an inscription from her dad tattooed on her foot. And every time she gets on the starting blocks, she looks at that inscription and it looks back at her and she knows her dad's with her and she's racing for a gold medal in less than an hour. It's really special stuff.
That is quite amazing. Anything else, Baz?
Mitch Larkin's also in the 100 backstroke final. He's a chance, but maybe just ever so slightly off the pace. But just enjoying the moments. Great performances by the Australians. It's been a fabulous games to be involved in, albeit we're involved in a different way. And to sort of sit with Ian Thorpe and Liesl Jones for these big swimming moments, it's a real privilege. We're very lucky to get to do what we do.
So how did you go in terms of trying to, I guess, be within the action at Tokyo in a small little room with a 30-inch TV?
The old Panasonic was there.
Could you still build that momentum that you need to call a race like that?
I needed Shani, our panel operator, to change the channels for me like he normally does. A lot of people have commented on how small the TVs are. Mind you, we are sitting very, very close. Look, you feed off the energy of the moment.
Yeah.
And once you're in that bubble, it's not much different to being in a commentary box anywhere, whether you're at the venue or not. And I must admit, it's not as difficult as people probably might think it is. And certainly with swimming, they stay in their lanes. It's probably one of the easiest sports to call off the TV. But you get lost in the moment. And from the moment they walk out on pool deck, you feel like you're there and you feel like you're calling the action as though you're side by side with them. So their performances really lift you, and that's what sets the tempo for you, and you just go with it.
Now, it's not very often, Baz, that you've called the big race yesterday, but it was upstage very early this morning with the women's triathlon. The girl from Bermuda got the chocolates, first ever for Bermuda, first since the bronze medal in the 1970 Olympics or whatever it was. So a big morning this morning in here.
Up and about the Bermudans, obviously, lost in that triangle somewhere. Well,
yes.
I can't. It wasn't It wasn't the absolutely number one thing on my list this morning, but I tell you what, anyone that wins a gold medal, that's fabulous.
It was number one on mine, Baz. I'll give you the tip.
We're all going out for dinner, Baz.
We're all going out for dinner. That's all I say. Yeah. Hey, mate, good luck again today. The swimming, I'm liking it on in the mornings. Yeah, it suits everyone. Yeah. And, of course, the Matildas play a little later on this afternoon, so we see Sam Kerr back in action as well. Well done, Baz. Get back stuck into it.
Good on you, Locke. Cheerio to everyone. Thanks to everyone for all their lovely messages as well. And looking forward to being back with you guys on Monday morning. But no, I really appreciate the support, everybody. And let's hope we get a few more in the coming days. Thanks, guys.
Absolutely. Baz doing a great job on the 7 commentary team, 92.9 Triple M Breakfast with Basil, Zave and Jenna.